Hello and welcome to today's European SharePoint Office 365 and Azure Community Webinar. My name is Shane and I'm delighted to be joined by Bert Janssen, Senior Service Engineer, SharePoint and OneDrive at Microsoft Belgium, who will be talking to you today about taking your SharePoint to the next level, transforming existing sites to the modern experiences. Remember to join in the conversation about today's webinar on Twitter. Our Twitter handle is @EuropeanSP and our hashtag is ESPC20. Don't forget to check out the Resource Center. This is updated daily with the latest blogs, ebooks, webinars, and how-to videos. Simply visit SharePointEurope.com and click the content link at the top. Interested in taking part in ESPC20 in Amsterdam this November? The call for speakers is now open at SharePointEurope.com, where you will also find details of our 30% discount offer, which ends next Thursday, the 27th of February. Also next week, we have the Microsoft Teams Week, one unmissable week of free online learning. Check out SharePointEurope.com for details. After the webinar, we will have a questions and answers session. Type any questions you have in the questions window. Questions will be selected and answered during the presentation. This webinar will be recorded and added to the Resource Center, where you'll be notified by email when it is available. And now I'm going to pass you over to our webinar presenter, Bert Janssen. Hello, Bert.
Hello. Hello, everyone. Welcome to this webinar about modernizing your existing sites. So my name is Bert Janssen. I'm a senior service engineer inside Microsoft. So I'm actually part of the SharePoint and OneDrive organization in Redmond, although I live and work from Belgium, which is for me really a good thing because I like Belgium. I like to stay here. Now, my team, it's the customer engineering team, and what we do is we work with our largest customers in the world in two ways, essentially. Like, one way is to handle escalations. So if, for example, a big customer calls Jeff Tepper with a problem, in the end that problem ends up in our team. The other side is with adoption. So our team really tries to drive adoption of modern experiences across all customers, not just the large ones, but across all customers. But many of the learnings, many of the tools that you will see today were created while working with those large customers. But now these tools are available for everyone. So with that quick agenda, we'll do an overview of modernization. What does modernization mean? Where are we today? We'll do a demo. Then we'll talk a bit about roadmap and a call to action for you. And at the very end, there are some Q&As. If there is enough time. Now, about Q&A, you can ask questions via the questions panel that was explained previously. We'll try to answer some questions maybe during the session. Some might have to move to the end. So we'll see how things go and how things flow. All right. Now, where do I find guidance around modernization? I'm new to modernization. I want to learn what actually is modernization, what tools are there, etc. So there is one address that you guys have to remember, and that's aki.ms/sppnp-modernize. That will bring you to our landing page on docs.microsoft.com, where all the modernization guidance is available for you. And that guidance is continuously being updated because we continuously ship new versions of tools and add more documentation to our set of docs. Okay, now, what is SharePoint modernization? What if, like, let's, I assume most of you, if all of you have classic SharePoint sites, that's why you are in this webinar. Now, okay, I have a classic team site. Does it then mean? How can I modernize that? And so let's kind of try to break that down in pieces and talk about the different aspects. So a first aspect of modern is getting the most out of your modern list and library experience. So nowadays, SharePoint already kind of forced you to use modern lists and libraries, although there are still ways for you to kind of say, like, no, I want to hold on my classic list experience. But overall, most customers, most people are using modern lists and library experience. And now, sometimes there can still be cases where SharePoint is showing your list in Classic where you want it to be shown in Modern. For example, a common use case that I see is that people have customized the list view page and put an additional web part on the list view page showing some additional content. At that point, if there's two web parts on the page, SharePoint will say like, yeah, sorry, I can't show this in Modern, so I keep this presentation of this particular list in Classic. That's something that you can fix. And we'll have tools for you to understand where are the places where you as a site admin, site owner, can fix a particular list to unblock it to be shown in a model. There's also a set of lists which are classic by design. I think the most notorious ones that always come kind of up during presentations are the calendar list, so the calendar view that we have on the classic calendar list and the classic task lists. So these are for now classic, so if you use those, we'll automatically switch to classic. And we're looking into having modern experiences for those, but nothing really concrete at this point in time to share. The second angle of modernization is after you've kind of ensured that you're using the modern list libraries, is thinking about, do I want to group connect this particular site? So in Office 365, in SharePoint Online, there are services that are dependent on the group. For example, if you want to use Teams together with your SharePoint site, or you want to use Yammer, or want to have a mailbox for your site, you can do that in SharePoint Online or Office 365. But then the part that connects Teams with the SharePoint site, that connects the mailbox with the SharePoint site, Yammer with the SharePoint site, etc., that's the group, the Office 365 group. Now, if your site does not have a group, it cannot use and consume Office group connected services like Teams, Yammer, Planner, etc. So for that, there's a solution. You can group connect your site. And once your site is group connected, you can then start pushing other services. For example, you can then also what we call Teamify your site, essentially creating a Teams team for your particular site, and then both are connected together. So if you go to the Teams environment and look at the files, you will see the documents from your SharePoint site, which is pretty cool. So these are then the scenarios depending on group connect. Then third area is pages. So every SharePoint site has pages. Depending on the type of site, it can be different types of pages as well. For example, your team site most likely will have wiki pages, classic wiki pages. You still might be using some web pages in there as well. If you have a blog site, you will have classic blog pages. If you happen to have a Delve blog, then you have Delve blog pages. Publishing sites have publishing pages. So there's pages, lots of pages in SharePoint. Now, if you want to go to a full modern environment, you would want to use modern pages, because modern pages are beautiful, they're responsive, they work on your mobile device, they have really cool new web parts, which are just way more smooth to work with. It's just a way better experience. So how do you go from the classic pages to the modern pages? That's one area to handle, and that's what we call page transformation, which we'll show in a demo as well. Bit of background on the blog page story. So if you have been following up on SharePoint, you might have read, might have seen a message in your tenant admin center about blog retirement. So we announced classic blog retirement a while ago, combined with Delve blog retirement. So what that means for classic blogs is that at a certain point, and it's a July timeframe, if I'm not mistaken, we will make it harder for you to create new classic blog sites, but the blog pages still stay around, the blog sites that you have still stay working. So there's no functionality loss, everything stays working, but we are encouraging you to use them. For the Delve blog pages, the story is slightly different. In July timeframe, we will effectively remove Delve blog pages from SharePoint Online. Now, overall, most people are not using Delve blog pages. It's not like a very heavily used feature, But if you're using Delve Blog Pages, think about what you want to do. You can, if you don't need these pages, fine. You let them disappear, all good. If you still want them, then please use Page Transformation to transform your Delve Blog Pages into modern pages. Then they're good to go again. You see also here at the slide, there's a little bottom right, this circle type of icon. Essentially, this indicates that these operations you do typically in place. Like if you have a team site, you will upgrade that same team site to be a modern team site. Whereas in the fourth bucket here, there's a different symbol. This is about publishing pages, publishing sites, publishing portals, your intranets. So if you have a publishing portal and you want to modernize that, you can't do that in place. You have to kind of do what we call a cross-site transformation or modernization. Because a classic publishing portal uses classic publishing pages, and that's not really compatible with modern pages. So you can't mix and match those in the same site collection. So therefore, in our guidance, what you see is that we guide you to a model where you read a classic publishing page in the source portal, and then you create a modern page in a new modern site, for example, a new communication site. All right, now, what if I did customize my previous SharePoint experience? SharePoint is a Swiss Army knife, so people tend to customize it, and we allowed many, many things, many types of customizations. Now, let's imagine I customize SharePoint. What do we need to do? Well, first thing is assess whether that customization is still important for you. Experience has learned that many customizations created like 5 years ago, 10 years ago, well, they probably are not super relevant anymore. But if the customization is still relevant and you still cannot do this out of the box in SharePoint, then you can always write a new SharePoint framework-based customization and use that on the modern pages. Your classic customizations will not work on modern pages, so you have to write a new customization if you need that. Related there is theming, branding. People always try to kind of make SharePoint look like their company brand, which is a good thing because you want to feel at home when you go to your SharePoint environment. In the past, you used classic themes combined with master pages, for example, or alternate CSS. Now, those techniques are not relevant anymore for modern pages. So if you modernize your site, then you would probably also want to think about, do I want to create a new modern tenant-wide team? So you can use a tenant that can create a team, which then can be consumed by all the sites. So imagine you creating like your tenant branding team, make that available, and then all the modern sites use that specific modern team. Lastly, what about workflow and InfoPod? These guys have been around for a long time. We have workflow SharePoint based upon SharePoint 2010, SharePoint 2013 in the system. We have InfoPod ready for more than 10 years. Now, these are both classic components. We don't have like a transformation technology to modernize them. Now, we do recommend you to move away from those both techniques. So for workflow, we recommend you to use Power Automate. Use the Power platform, like the old flow, now it's called Power Automate. And for InfoPod, use Power Apps, so the apps component from the Power platform. Both approaches are modern and future-proof, whereas Workflow and InfoPod are kind of really legacy old techniques. All right, no questions so far. Let's continue. If there's questions, guys, feel free to just put them in the question window. Happy to answer them. I'm going to take a sip of my coffee. Okay, now, why are there modernization tools? Why did we do this investment? And this whole modernization tool work investment is actually open source. So almost everything is available as open source components, which allows you to use them and even tailor them, tweak them, also provide feedback via those channels, or even alter the code, make changes, etc. So, but why tools? First of all, Well, for customers, it's not easy to understand why they need to use modern, why they need to use something new if something that you have works. So there's a learn component, and we'll have some tools for you to learn about modern and to kind of experiment with what is modern SharePoint and how can I use it in my organization. So we'll come to that in a second. There's also the what. If you're a small company, you might have a good view on what's inside your tenant. Now, if you're a medium-sized, large company, it's really hard to get a full view on what kind of sites are in my tenant, who is using Workflow, who is using Classic Blocks, are the Delta blocks being used? There's so many sites, how do you know? How do you kind of inventorize what you have? Because you want to know what you have before you start your modernization journey. And the third one is the how part. And although I'm from Microsoft, I have to admit that Microsoft maybe is not always super fast with shipping tools that enable you with the how. We tend to ship a lot of features, which is great, which gives you a lot of value, but sometimes it's quite hard to get from the old to the new. The manual approach always works, but what if you want to automate going from the old feature set to the new feature set? That's what in the how part, that's why we have the tools which we'll cover. So there's a question, what about automated modernization process plan to SharePoint Online? How will this work and transform the pages? So I'll come back to that question on the roadmap slide, which is the next one. So let's park that real quick. And then that's the same question. Yeah, okay. All right, so let's move to the roadmap slide. So where are we slide, the roadmap slide will be coming as well. Now in the learn pillar, what do we have today for you? We have Lookbook V2. Lookbook is a set of site designs created by our design team. So by the folks that designed the SharePoint UI. So really the designers, the guys that do nothing more than creating nice looking, fluently working designs. So they created those Lookbook sites. And the good thing with Lookbook sites is that it's not just a way to explain how to build a nice site on paper. You can also create those lookbook sites in your tenant. So we have the PnP provisioning portal where you can go to where you can create a lookbook site in your tenant. And we'll show that in a demo. We also have learning pathways, which is a really cool solution, which you can again grab via the provisioning portal, which provides your end users with the self-service help and adoption material for Office 365. So it contains material about SharePoint, about Office, about Teams, etc. What's available today in the analyze section? Mainly, we have the modernization scanner, which is the main component here, which can scan for list and libraries, group connect readiness. It can scan your pages to assess how ready those pages are to be modernized. It can analyze your publishing portals, do workflow, do InfoPod, and also do blog page scanning, including Delft blog page scanning. Will be shown in a demo as well. And then about modernization, about the tooling, what's available today. We have a partner offering or a customer offering. It's not necessarily for partners, but we have an offering which guides you through a step-by-step process on how to modernize sites. It contains a delivery guide. It contains the necessary scripts. We'll show some of them in the demo. Then we have the page transformation technology, which allows you to transform any classic page from SharePoint 2010, 2013, 16, 19, all the SharePoint on-prem versions to SharePoint Online or from online to online. So there was a question here I saw about what about SharePoint 2019? So for SharePoint 2019, the scanner today does not work for 2019. Scanner is scoped to SharePoint Online, but we have and the SharePoint migration team has an assessment tool which does something similar. It scans your SharePoint 2019 or 2016, 2013 environment. That might be a solution for you for that one. Page transformation works from SharePoint 2019. So you can transform SharePoint 2019 pages, but then as modern pages in SharePoint Online. So the target will be SharePoint Online. All right, let's move on. The key question I always get, quite often get, is like, oh, is classic going away? Do I need to be worried? Do I need to start rushing things? And the answer is no, classic is not going away. But there's always a but. In this case, the but is that we as Microsoft are not investing in classic anymore. We're not adding new features. We're not adding new capabilities. We might do like a security fix if that will happen, but that's about it more or less. So our focus is at our modern experiences and try to make those as good as possible, as complete as possible. I do know there are still some kind of parity gaps between classic SharePoint and modern SharePoint. And we are very, very committed to kind of remove those gaps. If there is gaps that block you from moving to modern, feel free to let us know via either SharePoint user voice, via the open source channels, via BNP. You can create an issue in our issue in our issue list for the modernization. You can reach out on Twitter to me, whatever. But let us know if there is something that really blocks you from moving to modern, because we want to know and we want to take away that blocker. But overall, our investment focus is on modern. I think that's a really important thing to announce. There's a question, did Microsoft just announce last week to automatically modernize classic sites? Well, yes and no. So we did announce that we are going to modernize the homepages of team sites. And only the uncustomized homepages of team sites will be modernized. So that's what you get from SharePoint as a product. That's a feature that we are rolling out, start to roll out actually now. So you will see this appearing, this happening in your targeted release tenants, think as of end of March timeframe, more or less. Now, this only covers the homepages of the uncustomized site. So what does it mean? Like imagine you create a classic team site and you change the homepage, then we're not touching that homepage, that will stay as is. Only if you created a classic team site and left the homepage as is, then it will be automatically modernized. So if you want to modernize all other pages in your site, you have to use page transformation, like was mentioned as well in the post and like I will show in the demo. Right, I think let's move to some demo. All right, I'm gonna switch to my other section. All right, let's minimize this. So let's first show lookbook. So in the learn pillar, how do you get inspired about modern? How can you try out modern in a safe way? I think the easiest way for that is go to, let me zoom the right screen. Here we go. Go to lookbook.microsoft.com, which brings you to this site where you see all modern types of sites. These are the sites created by the design teams. So for example, if I'm interested in the landing site, I can click in here and then I see how the site was built. So you see the homepage, the screenshot there, but you see also which features are used. In this case, we're using a vertical section. You see it right here, section background, the mega menu. So you see all those features with links to more details. We'll tell you which web apps are being used, etc. But the really cool thing is that you can simply click add to your tenant, and then you will be redirected to the PNP provisioning service, which allows you to install this in your tenant. Now we had a problem this morning. Okay, I was mentioning there was a little problem this morning with performance from the Azure side, but that should be fixed, and it is fixed, so we get the screen. So here I get the page where I can actually trigger the provisioning of the landing lookbook site in my tenant. Now, a caveat, you have to be a SharePoint admin in order to run this. So as a regular end user, you will not be able to do this because you don't have enough permissions. But I'm an admin and I can provide an email title. I can give it the site a URL. So let's call this the landing 1102. And I click provision. And once I do that, it will do some pre-checking. It will check whether the site is available, whether all the prereqs are met, like do I have everything ready? Okay, it kind of summarizes me like, okay, yeah, we'll create a new communication site with a custom welcome page, 7 articles will be created, sample content, etc. Click confirm, And now in the background, this provisioning starts to run. It will take a while to complete. So give it 10, 15, 20 minutes, depending on the template. But eventually it will complete and you will get informed via an email. All right, let's shift gears a little bit. Let me show you the landing in real. So here is the landing site. So this is what you get once the provisioning is done. So a full working site where you can say edit and can start changing things. So this way you can install those modern sites in your tenant and play around with them. You can change them and kind of put another team on top of it, update the content, make it something that works for your organization, and then show that to other stakeholders in your organization. The best way to learn it is just to experience it, to play with it, etc. All right, let's discard changes here. So there's a question, will SharePoint 2016 stay classic forever? And the answer is yes. Sure, SharePoint 2016, 2013, they only have classic UI and we're not shipping any modern UIs over there. SharePoint 2019 has modern UI, does support modern pages, modern sites, and the upcoming SharePoint version, on-prem version, will most likely have more modern capabilities, but nothing to be disclosed at this point. So on-prem versions get more and more modern versions, but SharePoint Online will always be the leading one when it comes to modern capabilities. Okay, good. So let's talk a bit about the scanner. So if you want to use the modernization scanner, because you want to, for example, understand what's inside my environment, which sites are ready to be group connected, for example, which pages can be modernized, etc., then you can go to this URL. Let me zoom in again over here. So ak.ms/svpnp-modernization-scanner, which will bring you to this page where you get a getting started guide. Now, using the scanner is fairly easy, but you need to set up things to start using it. So first of all, you have to download the scanner. The scanner is an EXE, an executable. I know some people are kind of don't like to run an EXE, download it from the internet, but rest assured, this is safe. It's signed by Microsoft. It's open source. You can check the source code if you don't really trust it. But we have hundreds of customers using this on a monthly basis, so that's all good. Then once you have the scanner downloaded, you need to prepare for the scan. So a scan, depending on what you want to scan, you need to do different things. If you want to scan one particular site, then it's easiest to just enter username and password credentials that have permissions to that site and you run the scan. If you, however, want to scan your complete tenant, then the easiest way is to use an app-only approach. So app-only allows you to get access to all the sites without a specific user and password. And there's two ways to configure that, using Azure AD or using SharePoint app only. So the Azure AD approach is the recommended one because the SharePoint approach is kind of, it is still there supported, but it's the old thing. This is the new thing. And this guide, if I open this real quick, we don't have time to really walk through all the details here, but this guide will kind of take you step by step on how to do that. You get a certificate, then you create an Azure AD application, register a certificate to that and configure things. So it's not really hard and it's really documented. So once you have done that, you can then use that Azure AD application and that certificate in the scanner. So the actual scan itself is wizard based, the default, or command line based. You can choose. But for most folks, running the wizard is probably the easiest one. So with that, let's see if I, let's open up my Explorer. And it's opening up on the wrong window. Give me a sec. Modernization. Almost there. Okay, I'm opening up the scanner. It will be there in a second. But yeah, so for the scan, the wizard approach is the easiest, but there's also a command line approach. If I scroll down here, at the very end, you will see there's a command line that you can use to run the scan as well. So the wizard should load in a second. Sometimes it takes a bit of time to load. Meantime, there's a question like, is there a scanner for SharePoint 29 on-prem? No, so this scanner, this one that I'm showing right now, does not work for SharePoint 2019 on-prem. It only works for SharePoint Online. So for SharePoint 2019 scanning, you can use the tools provided by the SharePoint migration team. Okay, where is my scanner staying? Come on, show. Is it showing something somewhere behind? Interesting. Give it a bit more time to load. Sometimes the virus can just block it. So this tend to kind of slow down things. Let me answer some questions in the meanwhile. So we talked about 2019, 2016. There is a question about the home site. So the shared site that I showed previously, this one here, this is what we call the landing site. So if you go to the provisioning service and you use the landing one, then you get the one that I showed over here. All right, but in the meantime, the scanner loaded. What you can do, the first step is provide authentication information. I talked about different options, Azure AD App Only or credentials. So Azure AD is the preferred one. Now for demo's sake, I'm just going to enter some fake data because I'm not actually going to run the scan. So hit next. You can scan a complete tenant. Let me actually zoom in because maybe this is slightly small at your site. So you can either scan the complete tenant or you can scan for a particular set of sites, or you can specify a CSV file with sites. So there's three options. Let's take my complete tenant, Contoso. All right, next. Then here, let me zoom in again. You can choose what is the scan mode. So you can scan for a particular operation. Like if you're interested in Group Connect readiness, you can scan just for that. That goes quicker than scanning for everything because there's also a full scan mode, but then that takes more time because way more data is read and analyzed. So depending on your environment, depending on your size, you might want to kind of scope the scan to a particular component. Let's say this Group Connect readiness. And then here you can finalize some options. Maybe you can bump the number of threads. There's a parallel scan. You can set the separator settings, whether you're US-based or Euro-based, you might want to change that. Then you hit start scan and the scanner starts to run. Depending on your size of your tenant, the scan might take 10 minutes, 50 minutes, half an hour, 1 hour, 10 hours, more than one day for really large tenants. So if you want to run this on a large tenant, run it on a machine that can stay running, like on Azure VM or machine in your office that you don't have to shut down. Don't start this on your work machine, on your laptop before you want to go home, because then you have to cancel the scan. All right, now we don't have time to wait for a scan result, but I can actually already show you some of the output. So I've opened up a couple of reports coming out of the scan. So the scanner will create a number of Excel-based dashboards that you see here. And for example, this is an Excel-based dashboard, and also CSV files. So there's CSV file, the raw data, the raw scan results, and then this dashboard has read that data and kind of prepared it for you as a way to consume it, to view it. But you can use both approaches. You can use the dashboard to have do some quick analysis, then use the CSV data, for example, to drive upgrade processes or other things inside your organization. So in this case, I can, for example, filter on, give me the sites which are ready for being group connected. So it already filtered down the list of sites. So here is this list of sites that are ready. I don't have already group connected sites for the team because that doesn't work, of course. Here you can see I have some warnings. I think that's interesting, showing you like, okay, if you want to group this site, do remember that using Test Classic pages at this point in time. So yeah, you might have a difference in user experience. So there's a warning. Or another typical one is subsites. So I'm using subsites. What about subsites in Group Connect? Okay, the group is for the site collection. And the Group Connect services are for the root side of the site collection typically. Now you can still have a subsite, it still works fine, but you might want to be aware of that fact. So this report gives you necessary warnings to understand really what does it mean? What are the potential impacts if I start, in this case, group connecting sites? Another one in this category is blogs. This is a simpler report where I can show, give me all my Delve blogs, because hey, Delve blogs is going away. So I want to probably modernize those Delve blog pages. And here I see like, okay, I only have one Delve blog site collection. It contains one post. So pretty simple. You can filter on top with let's take Classic. So then you can start filtering. Give me the recent ones from 2019. Okay, then you see the data filtering. And again, the data is available here. If I right click and unhide, there is like a blog pages sheet, which you can use to filter as well, because this is the data which drives the dashboard. But also this data again lives as CSV files in the scanner output as well. So the scanner at the end gives you like a ton of data and effects. Sometimes it might be hard for you to fully understand what's in and how to use it. So if that's the case, you can also go to documentation again. So in the scanner page to get started, like this one, there's also a subdivision which explains each report. For example, if I take the block one, the one that I showed at the very end, here you get more explanation about the data. So this is the Excel, this is the CSV file that's being generated. It has these columns, a description, what are key takeaways? So like, how do you filter the Excel or the CSV files to kind of get some learnings? All of this is in here available for you. All right, I think we should shift to modernizing. So we talked about the Learn, which is the lookbook site, and this is a way for you to learn modern. We talked about the Analyze section, where you can kind of start to get more data about your SharePoint environment. Now let's talk about actual modernization. So what I have here is a classic team site. This classic team site does have a classic customized homepage. You see, is a wiki page. It has, if I go over here to drone additions, it has a custom list using JS link as a way to customize the list rendering. Come on. Please load. Here we go. So you see this color boxes is done using JS link. So it's a customized list. It also has a footer at the bottom. You see this this footer over here. You see this background image. So there's a custom theme with some custom fonts. What else do we have? We have a number of pages in here, which are custom pages as well. So we have a WebArt page. Let's open this one real quick. So this is a classic page. If you put this in edit mode, you'll see that it's classic. All right, see? So all in all, this is a customized theme site. Now I want to modernize this one. What do we do? So the first step is kind of using our guidance. Let's go, let's go back over here. Let's, where did I open? Did I open this one? I have so many tabs opened it. let's go. Let's open a new tab. Let's just find our way. Let's go to our modernization guidance. We have modernization guidance over here, SharePoint modernization guidance. And here you see a step-by-step approach that I'm going to show in a demo. So you can go work from here if you want to use this. If you want to do the same thing that I did in a demo, this is a way to kind of get started. But there's also all the scripts. So if you go over here, modernization scripts, I end up in our SPDEV modernization repository, which contains all the open source modernization tools, including all the scripts. So these are the scripts, for example, that I'm going to show you in a second. These scripts allow you to modernize a full site collection. And you can find them under github.com/sharepoint/SPDEV modernization. All right, and there's even more scripts. So there's also scripts for group connect, page transformation, etc. So all the modernization scripts are available from here. Now, let's do this actual modernization. So the first step, I'm going to validate. So what I have here is a site collection CSV file that where I kind of wrote down like all the sites that I want to modernize with their intended group alias, because I will be group connecting the sites. So a group does have a unique alias. So I'm specifying my alias over here with some properties about public group. Do I want to have a Teams team created? Do I want to modernize pages, etc.? So that information is listed in this CSV file, which then allows me to call my validate script. So we have a validation script. So if I call this one, validate site collection input, then it will ask me once it's loaded for my site collections file. So site collections.csv. And now this script will check things. For example, I'm specifying a group name. Is that group name unique? Didn't I use this group name already before? Is it following the Azure conventions, at the Azure policy set for group names, etc.? So there's a ton of checks to ensure that your input for modernization is valid. So in this case, this modernized 01 site in my input file was already modernized because it already has a group, so I can't group connect it anymore. This one is using a team which is not available. So the only valid one is the 02 one, one which we are going to modernize. But imagine you kind of preparing your modernization, having a wave of sites to modernize and run this through this validation script to kind of pre-check things. Once you're ready with the pre-checking, you can call the actual modernization script, modernize site collections script. This one will take the site collections file as input, or it can take just one particular site collection. So you can choose to kind of drive multiple site collections at once, or just do this like a one site collection at the go, which is what I'm going to do right now. So I'm going to copy the URL of my site collection and not this window. Sorry for that. This window over here. Here is our team site. Okay, let's copy the URL. And then let's launch the script. So modernize site collections. Oops. All right. So if I launch it, it will ask me to either enter a single site collection URL or a CSV file. So I'm going to enter the site collection URL. I'm going to create a group for this one. So let's call this group ESPC 2019 modernize 02. It will be a default private group. Do we want to have a Teams created? Yeah, sure. Default is true, so we hit enter. Do we want to modernize the pages in this particular site? Yes, true. Enter. Do we modernize branding? Sure. Tenant team. I actually forgot the name for this one, so let's leave it empty for now. The location label can be empty, and now it starts to connect and do the work. Now, this is for a reason. This is a PowerShell script. It's not some, not that we do like PowerShell a lot, PHP PowerShell, but we chose to make this as a PHP PowerShell script because it allows you to also change it. So you can kind of plug in your own experience, your own environment, your own desire when you want to modernize the sites. So if I open up the script, and modernize site collections. You'll see there is a, in the script, there's a modernize site function, which is the bulk function, the one that does the actual work. And in here, you can, as a user, start making changes. So for example, this one is removing modernization blockers, is doing some template checks, then it's enabling a modern page feature, etc. Installing custom solutions. So if you are replacing classic customizations with modern ones, you might want to also automate the installation of the classic, of the modern customizations via the script. So you can do it over here. Then we are removing the old branding. So we are resetting the master pages. We are removing alternate CSS. Once that's done, we start to modernize the pages. So all the pages in the site will be modernized using the converter PNP client side page commandlet. So this commandlet, which is a commandlet inside PNP PowerShell, allows you to modernize a page into a modern page. Once that's done, we continue. We are going to actually check if we're already group connected. If not, we're going to add the teams, but typically you end up over here. Going to first group connect. So the add-pnp Office 365 group the site commandlet will group connect the site. So it will create a new Office 365 group and connect it to that particular team site. We copy the group owners copy the site owners to the group owners, site members to the group members, etc. Doing all that for you. Then we create a Teams team if you propose that, and so on. So and then it's about cleaning up, and then we should be done. So pretty extensive script, but it is a script. It allows changes. So and do make changes to it. It is there for you to change. All right. Now let's see if this script is still running. Still running. So it should be done. It modernized the pages. If you see the output over here, now it's calling Group Connect. So let's give it a few more seconds to finish. It shouldn't take that long anymore. Then once this is done, we are going to flip back to slides and do some slides and have some time for Q&A. All right, but this is done. You see green, there's no red in this output, which is a good sign. So it meant that everything hopefully went well. So let's go back to my site. Let's click on the icon. Now the same site, I'm reloading the same site. And what you will see is that you get a modern homepage. You get a modern footer here, the bottom. So this is a custom footer, SharePoint framework-based footer that we injected. So this replaces the old footer. If I go to the pages, you will see that, come on, loading up. Pages do load, here we go. We have modern versions of the pages. So the original pages are renamed to previous underscore. So this DJ 1000 page that we showed previously, now is the original one is this one. This one is a new one. This one is a modern page version of that one, where you see the same page within the modern equivalent, and so on. So everything has been kind of transformed in place. Pages, branding, list and libraries, customizations. So you can all kind of integrate that in one big upgrade push. All right, now let's move back to slides. Quick update on where we are. So last week we released 2.8 version of the modernization scanner. Scanner keeps on evolving. You've seen the scanner. When there's a new version, you will be notified to pick up the new version. So if there are things that you want to get changed, let us know there. Same for page transformation. The February release was actually released yesterday, and I tweeted about it this morning. New things there are improved 2010 support for WebAR handling and some additional options for publishing page transformation. The modernization partner guidance that I showed that as well. So the script that I used to kind of modernize that full site, that's kind of a piece of a full partner / customer guidance, which you can find via the address here on the slide. So it has not just the script, it also has kind of delivery guide in PowerPoint, a really detailed delivery guide walking you through all the steps. It has documentation pages on docsandmics.com with additional details. So everything that you need to start modernizing. Now, roadmap-wise, what's coming up? In the Learn pillar, we'll have some modern success cases coming up with some videos and some really cool use cases. We are also adding additional templates. So we're looking into a SharePoint success site pretty soon, and then also a new employee onboarding site. So these are sites that we as Microsoft create and design, which you can then use to kind of not just use modeling, but also provide value to our organization. In the analyze pillar, the big thing is that we are looking into making the scanner available as a service. So instead of you downloading an EXE, you can go to a site and say, hey, run the scan for me. And then we will run the scan for you, and then you get the results. So timing-wise, this is out for several months still. So best case will be around SharePoint conference, but we'll see. Then in the modernized pillar, so what's on the roadmap? The homepage modernization, we talked about it already and there were some questions. So just to repeat it again, the homepage modernization will only modernize uncustomized team site homepages. All the other pages will be left as they are today. If you want to modernize the other pages, then you have to use page transformation like I've shown in the modernization demo. That's the way to modernize all the pages. You can also modernize the full site. And so the open source tooling, the community tooling that I'm using, that I'm showing, does a full site modernization. The native tools in SharePoint Online itself focus on homepage modernization from uncustomized team sites for now. We are also about to ship a feature that allows you to transform your team site into a communication site. So then you get the top navigation, you can use full width sections for modern pages. So essentially your team site becomes a communication site. And this is handy when you're using your team site more as kind of a communication channel. Then if you modernize that team site, it makes sense to kind of transform it into a communication site versus a group connected team site. We're also looking into having a modernization offering for portals. We have one for team sites, the one that I showed, but then looking into having something similar for portals. And similar to the scanner, looking into being able to offer you modernization as a service. So you can go to a service, to a site, and trigger modernization workloads from there. So envision going to our PNP service catalog and say, like, I want to modernize this particular site, provide the site details, and then we modernize the site for you. That's kind of what we're looking at. Important, stop further growing your modernization debt. So if you today still provision classic sites, you have to ask yourself, should I do that? Because every classic site that you create today still has to be modernized later on. Eventually, you will be modernizing those. So let's try to stop doing that. Let's create modern sites. Let's try to use modern as much as possible already from now. So that will kind of make your upgrade work in the future smaller. There's a question, will home pages of all classic sites in my tenant be changed to modern if the classic home pages are not customized? And the answer is yes. So any uncustomized classic team site homepage will be modernized. If you look at the communication around it, there is also a way for you to opt out that change, but that's a web scope change, web scope to opt out. So there's ways to prevent this, but I think typically it's a good thing to happen. So, but if you really want to prevent it, there is ways to do that as well. Alrighty. Start modernizing where it makes sense. Modernization is like a bit like this person riding uphill. It takes energy, it takes money. It's not a free thing. So so you can then ask yourself the question, does it really make sense for me and my organization to modernize my team sites, which no one has been using since 2015? You can, it's your choice, but maybe it makes more sense to modernize the actually used sites, spend the energy over there, and then maybe later on modernize those old sites if you want, but kind of decide whether it makes sense, yes, no. also start today. There's nothing holding you back. All the tools are there. If there's blockers, then please reach out to us, let us know. But I think every customer should be able to start modernizing today. Here are some resources, which kind of point you to the things that I've been showing in the demo. There's a lot of modernization guidance and tools available. Sometimes it's hard to find them, but hopefully this will help you kind of figure out where to find what. And with that, I want to leave a few minutes for additional Q&A, and I'm looking at the chat window for additional questions to answer.
Thanks for a great presentation. And yes, now we'll have more questions and answers. I know, Bert, you have been taking questions as they were coming in, so thank you very much for that. But should anybody wish to ask a question now in the chat, in the questions window, please do so. So there is a few coming in. Bert, will I just copy and paste them over to you?
Yeah, you can copy and paste. I'll try to answer what I see popping in here.
Okay.
So there's one. What is the definition of customizations for the classic site? So that probably relates to the homepage modernization feature. So uncustomized in this case means just default. So the homepage, the wiki page was not changed. If you put one letter of text in it, it is considered customized. So any change to the homepage that you did, any text addition, even if you put a space in there, will flag it as customized. So only if you create a theme site and left it as is, only then it will be modernized. So if you have a custom provisioning scenario where you create a theme site and then customize it, then most likely that will not be impacted. Let me scroll in the chat window to see if there's other questions.
Yeah, there was another one there. Goes, we use classic site as landing pages. If we use SiteSwap, what will happen to substitute to sub-site connected to it?
Yeah. So SiteSwap. So if you have a classic root site like contoso.sharepoint.com, and you want to modernize the root of your tenant, then SiteSwap is the easiest and the recommended approach. So you create like a new communication site, and then you swap sites. Now, swapping means that the communication site becomes the root site, and the other one is a new URL. So in this case, subsite stays with the site that's being swapped out, so there is no impact.
Okay. The next one there is what is the modern web part for calendar?
So, the modern web part for calendar, there's two options for you. We have an events web part, which is a list, kind of a list-based view. It's not like an actual calendar view, but it does show you all the events. That does though have some limitations around recurring events, etc. But if you have a basic calendar usage, the events web part is good for that. Alternatively, if you group connect the site, you can also use a group mailbox with an Exchange group calendar. That might be an option as well. What happened to InfoBot forums? List editor with InfoBot will be able to edit the forums in InfoBot after that. So if you InfoBot is still there, still supported. So yes, if you're using InfoBot, it will flip the classic and it will still work. What are the plans for modernizing calendars? This ask keeps on coming up, so we have definitely heard about it. I cannot really share any details because I'm not in the team owning this particular functionality. But I think you've made it loud and clear that you want to have modern calendars. So as mentioned previously, there are some workarounds with the event web part, but like a real calendar view, like the classic one with recurring events, is something that's not yet available, but hopefully soon in the future. How do we modernize an on-prem classic site? For on-premises, the modernization tools that I've been showing, they don't work. They work for online. Also, page transformation works for on-prem to online. So doing an in-place modernization in classic SharePoint, then you would have to be in SharePoint 2019 to start with, because SharePoint 2013, 2016, et cetera, they don't have any modern experiences. But in 2019, you could start doing that, but there is no fully supported path, so it will be quite hard to do it, to be honest.
Great. On behalf of the ESPC community, thank you, Bert, for taking the time today to complete this webinar. We really appreciate it. Brilliant. So thank you, Bert. This is the end of today's webinar, but just before you go, just a quick reminder of a few things upcoming here at ESPC. The call for speakers is currently open, and if you are interested in attending ESPC 20, we have a 30% discount ticket offer running at the moment. So please see sharepointeurope.com for full details. Also, please join us next week for our next upcoming webinar, where we have Teams Week, an unmissable week of free online learning. That is the end of today's webinar. Please see sharepointeurope.com for further detail of all upcoming webinars in relation to Teams Week next week and the offers that I mentioned. Thank you for joining us today, and thank you again to Bert Janssen from Microsoft Belgium for taking the time today. Take care and goodbye.